Good afternoon, everyone. Good afternoon. Woo! Welcome to Cecil College's 54th commencement. We are honored, we are delighted, we are pleased to have you all with us today. Thank you. Now at this time, I very kindly, respectfully ask if you can please silence your cell phones and any electronic devices as we honor our graduates, the class of 2023. Are we ready? I am. Everyone, at this time, I ask that you please rise for the processional and remain standing for the singing of the national anthem.
Thank you. Honored guests, our national anthem will be performed by June Su. Please stand.
Say, can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched, were so gladly streaming, and the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that the flag was still there. Oh, say does the star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the home of the
Please be seated. Cecil College is a place that provides each of you with the opportunity to create your individual path to better future through education, to follow your dreams and discover your passions. During your time at Cecil College, each member of the college community was here to support you in reaching your academic goals, and we will always be here for you. We remain committed to providing accessible, quality education so that each of our students has the ability to truly own their future. We are all well aware of what it takes to complete college: time, commitment, perseverance, family support, geographic access, and financial resources. Furthermore, many of you in the graduating class today are first-generation students. Many of you are parents or care for a parent or a relative. Many of you work full-time or part-time jobs. In addition, each of you has personal responsibilities in life. You set goals for yourself, and you started the journey to earn a college degree or certificate. We know how hard you have worked and the sacrifices that you have made in order for you to be sitting here today. This is the day that we celebrate your accomplishments, and we are honored to share this day with you and your loved ones. We are proud of each and every one of you. As you enter or re-enter the workforce, take a licensure exam, or transfer to a four-year institution, know that your Seahawk strength and perseverance will shine and carry you far in life. Those same qualities assisted you through the long nights of studying, the long days of challenging yourself to do more when you really thought you could not do it. Well, we knew you could do it, and we knew we would be here with you today to meet this important moment and say, congratulations, you are now Cecil College graduate. Education is one of the best investments you make in yourselves, and we know that education is one of the best investments we can make in America's future. Community colleges are essential in making dreams come true for students, and every year, nearly half of all the undergraduate students in the United States were enrolled at some time in a community college. Today, Cecil College is awarding 330 associate degrees and 23 certificates to 340 students. The college serves over 5,000 credit and continuing education students annually. I extend a thank you to our supporters in the county, state, and region, and community, and to our students, our staff, our faculty, for being part of Cecil's student success. Most importantly, I want to express my sincere appreciation to Cecil College's faculty and staff. We are fortunate to have outstanding faculty and staff members impacting students' lives each and every day, and our faculty and staff work very, very hard to prepare students for that successful career or transition to another college or transition to the workforce. So thank you. To all Cecil College graduates walking across the stage today, this is a beginning and not an end to your ability to own your future. Success is never a one-person job, and your continued access to Cecil College's resources will allow you to create opportunities through networking, through the Alumni Association, career services, and outstanding lifelong learning programs. Cecil College graduates, congratulations on achieving your goal. I see great things in your future, and I know that your success at Cecil College is truly just the beginning. Whatever you choose to do in life, make certain you do it well, and commit all of your talents to that success. And remember, you will always be a Seahawk, so please keep in touch with us. Let us know of your accomplishments as you confidently advance toward your future endeavors. Again, congratulations. We are very pleased with your achievements. At this time, I'd like to introduce some special guests. I ask that each of you stand and be acknowledged, and that the members of the audience hold your applause until all of the introductions in the group have been made. The members of the Board of Trustees give countless hours of volunteer services to the college on your behalf. Would the trustees participating in today's graduation stand as I call your name? Mr. Mark G. Mortensen, Chair of the Board of Trustees. Dr. Sidney Teal, Vice Chair. Mr. Raymond Hamm and Mrs. Donna Horgan are representing the Board of Trustees today. You may be seated. Members of the Cecil College Foundation are dedicated ambassadors of the college. They increase awareness and support for the college within the region by creating partnerships with individuals, with businesses, with organizations, private foundations, and they help raise dollars for scholarships, instructional equipment, professional development, capital projects, and other educational needs. Special thanks to attendance today, our foundation chair, Mr. Francis L. Mita, chairman. On behalf of Congressman Aaron D. Harris's office, thank you to Ms. Jackie Gregory for attending today's celebration. Our county executive and county council members give countless hours of service to Cecil County and to the college. Today, we are joined by these outstanding friends of the college, members of the county council present today, Mr. Bob Meffley, Ms. Rebecca Hamilton, Ms. Donna Culberson, Ms. Jackie Gregory, and Mr. Al Miller. Administration for the Early College Academy in the Cecil County Public Schools include Dr. Jeffrey Lawson, Superintendent, Dr. Jennifer Hammer, Associate Superintendent of Educational Services, Dr. David Foy, Executive Director, Secondary Education, Ms. Diana Hawley, Cecil County Public School Board President, Mr. Tierney Davis, Cecil County Public School Board Member, Mr. James Letkeeb, principal of Elkton High School. Mrs. Kimberly Williams, principal of Perryville High School. And now our partners at Oxford High School, Dr. Margaret Billings-Jones, assistant superintendent, and Mr. Jamie Cannaday, principal at Oxford. I am pleased to also recognize Margaret Lehman and Heather Ullman from Definitions and Interpreting, who are sign language interpreters for this year's commencement exercises. Other platform guests with us today include Dr. Christy Dreyer, Vice President of Academic Programs, Dr. Veronica Dougherty, Dean of Arts and Science, Dr. Chris Castillo, President of Academic Senate, Dr. Kim Joyce, Vice President of Student Services, Ms. Michelle Williams, Executive Director of Human Resources, Mr. Brandon Bryce, Vice President of Community Relations and College Advancement, Mr. Christopher Mills, Vice President of Finance and Administrative Services, Dr. Nancy Norman Marzella, Dean of Health and Human Services, Mr. Miles Dean, Dean of Community and Career Education. Additionally, Cecil College Outstanding Students for 2023, Matthew Todd Enlow, Evan Thomas LaPointe, Lauren Ashley LaPointe, Emma Bregan Nell, Matthew Allen Wallace. Also on the platform are student speakers who will provide a welcome and share their reflections with you today. Dominic A. Harris. Julia Ariana Davis. Camille Isabella Gaskell. Thank you. Would the Cecil College faculty, including adjunct faculty, please stand? Woo. I am pleased to acknowledge the highly credentialed and outstanding members of our faculty who impact students' lives and work hard to prepare them for a successful career or transition to another institution. You have so much to be proud of because research indicates that your students will continue to succeed when they transfer and leave Cecil College. Thank you. Also, I would like to acknowledge the Student Support Services staff who are with students from the first time you arrived on campus, and they are with you today at graduation. Family, friends, colleagues, college staff, trustees, our foundation members, student support groups, and administrators, thank you for helping make this day possible. Honored guests, at this time, I present the Chair of the Board of Trustees, Mr. Mark G. Mortensen.
Welcome, everyone, to Cecil College's graduation ceremony. My name is Mark Mortensen, and I'm the proud chair of the Cecil College Board of Trustees. I'm both honored and grateful to have the privilege of speaking to you today. Dr. Bolt, esteemed faculty, friends of the graduates, staff, my fellow trustees and I, trustees, please stand. Thank you for all your efforts to bring this great class in front of us today. Graduates, now to you. You should be very proud. You and your diploma or certificate will never be separated from you. It is yours forever. There's something about you, about every one of you. Your upbringing, your background that got you here. Something has driven you to complete your courses and overcome all your personal challenges. You've earned the rite of passage. You're going into a realm where not everyone goes. These commencement exercises, The important ceremonial activities, all of the highly appropriate symbolism, reminds us all here of the importance of what you've each achieved. My fellow trustees and I, as well as the faculty and staff of the college, do applaud you. You've experienced the exhilaration of learning. Never stop learning. I hope you'll find that wisdom, not money, is more important for your ultimate happiness. Please remember that when you are challenged, and you will be, there'll be many tough choices in your life. The most important thing in your life, live it with integrity. Don't give in to peer pressure. Don't try to be something you're not. Please live your lives as an honest and compassionate person. Look for the positives in everyone. Don't let others convince you that any class or fellow of human being deserves less than your full respect. Please contribute to society in a meaningful way. Live your lives with a sense of urgency every day. While the future is uncertain, it's always uncertain. Don't just accept the challenges that come your way. Enjoy them. Embrace them. Those challenges is what make you grow in life. Climb the mountain not to plant your flag, but to embrace the challenge of the climb. Climb so that you can see the world. Don't climb it so the world can see you. In view of everyone that has brought you to this accomplishment today, I ask you, take a specific moment today, tomorrow, or in the week, and expressly say thank you to all those people that helped get you there. It will mean so much to them, whether it's a faculty member, a friend, a fellow student, or most importantly, your family members. You've succeeded because of the aid and love of others that have been and will remain in your lives. Today, we celebrate what you have done. We celebrate all of your achievements, and we are certain of one thing on this day: you will not let us down. Thank you.
Thank you, Trustee Mortensen. Dominic A. Harris is today's welcome speaker. Dominic?
Good afternoon, Cecil College students, faculty, staff, administration, families, and friends. My name is Dominic Harris, and it's with immense pleasure that I welcome you all to our 2023 graduation ceremony. It is an honor to be speaking to you all today. As B.B. King said, the beautiful thing about learning is that no one can take it away from you. Fellow graduates, we've worked hard. It has been a long journey, but we have all attained our goal. The time and experience here at Cecil College will benefit us no matter where we go next. Today, let us acknowledge all the obstacles we've overcome and the bumps and U-turns life threw at us. Today, let us celebrate our achievements and thank the people who helped us get here. This is not just a day for us to feel proud of ourselves. It is also a day for our friends and family to be proud of us as well. They have seen our journey and know how much has gone into this moment. Maybe they've sacrificed some things to help make this happen for us. So this is their day too. Sandra Bullock said it best: when someone who loves you hugs you, hug them back with two arms. Don't do the one-arm hug, because when you hug someone with two arms, it allows you to lean on somebody, and we all need someone to lean on. Some people ask me how I'm still pushing through despite all the challenges I faced. It's by the grace of God that I serve. I can promise you that if it were not for the strength that He gives me each and every day, I would not be a part of the crowd on today. Through his grace, too, we have great professors, staff, administration, who have supported us along the way. And we want to say thank you. Thank you for your support. So with that being said, welcome, welcome all to our 2023 graduation ceremony.
Thank you, Dominic. We are pleased to have two students reflect on the experiences they had while attending Cecil College. These students were nominated by their faculty to be today's speakers. Please welcome our first student speaker, Julia Adrian Davis.
Hey, everyone. 2 years ago, I never would have expected the varieties of experiences that I've had, the lessons I'd learned, and the friends I'd make during my time here at Cecil. In the recent weeks as graduation has approached, I found myself thinking a lot about the person that I saw myself as when I started Cecil and the person that I see myself as now. As a psychology student, I think the sense of self is one of the most revealing indicators of growth. Philosopher David Hume had one of the most compelling theories about the self. Hume theorized that self was not something stagnant that stood untouched by time, but rather it was a living, breathing thing that shifted and flowed. By his thinking, the person you are when you're born isn't the person you'll be when you die. In fact, the person you are right now isn't the person you'll be next year or even when you wake up tomorrow. Day by day, second by second, you're a slightly different person. Like the famous ship of Theseus, each new piece of you is altered and replaced until at some point you're not quite the same you that you were before. Better yet, maybe the self is best described as the waters that the ship of Theseus sails on. Rising and falling with the tides, lapping against the shore, breaking on the rocks, slowly and surely chipping away at the beaches and cliffs that confine and define her, infinitely vast and deep. Never the same from one moment to the next. Hume's theory reminds me a lot of my fifth birthday. I was so incredibly excited to finally be 5 years old because, like I showed my mom by counting on my hands, for my first time in my life, I would be a whole hand. After weeks that felt like years, the morning of my birthday finally came. I clambered down the side of my bunk bed and I ran to the stand mirror. And you would not believe my disappointment when I saw the exact same face in the mirror that I had seen the night before. It was the same nose, the same eyes, the same freckles, all the same face staring back at me. See, I thought that when I turned 5, I would look 5. But my mom gently explained that I wouldn't change all at once. Slowly, day by day, I'd start to look a little more 5. I still make the same mistake now. I want to instantly fix all of the parts of myself that don't fit my idea of who I should be, what I should look like. But especially 5-year-old me, and David Hume would agree, nobody changes all at once. When I started at Cecil, I had no idea how to study for exams, how to clean gram stains, or what I wanted to do after I graduated. But bit by bit, I grew the knowledge and the skills to tackle each new experience. I joined study groups, spent late nights poring over notes and sipping coffees, and I learned that rubbing alcohol cleans gram stain spills off of laboratory floors. And by taking field trips, attending talks, investing myself in my work, and staying inquisitive, my understanding of the academic and professional doors open to me began to blossom. To conclude, change is inevitable. To live is to grow, and to grow is to change. You can't stop it, that you can furnish yourself with a good, rich environment for your roots to take hold in. Dig out the rocks and the roots that impede your growth and water your mind with learning. Simply put, wherever your path leads you after today, I ask that you simply remember to give yourself time and space to grow into the person that you'll become. Thank you.
Thank you, Julia. Please welcome our second student speaker, Camille Isabella Gaskell.
Hello, Cecil College's graduating class of 2023. My name is Camille Gaskill, and many of you may not know me, but I was an engineering student here at Cecil College, and I am now a graduate. My journey to Cecil College is quite a unique one. I am the youngest of three children and the last to go to college, and with that, I found myself facing a lot of pressure. Pressure from my peers, pressure from my friends, pressure from my professors, and pressure from my parents wanting me to do well. But the major pressure comes from being the last of four family members to graduate from this college. My mom and two older sisters all graduated from Cecil at the same time with some of the highest honors and awards that this school had to offer. Talk about leaving massive shoes to fill. So, when I started here, I wasn't sure whether I would match up to them. Would I achieve the same things? Would I get even close to their success? Would I meet the standard they set out for me? This is something I faced often early in my time at Cecil, but the longer I stayed, the more I learned, and the more I realized that I not only achieved what they set out for me, but I did more than that. I surpassed it. I made them proud, but made myself even prouder. They didn't walk the halls knowing they needed to live up to their last name, but I did. They didn't have to go to class or go through this journey without having a mom or sister in the next classroom, but I did. They didn't attend college through a global pandemic, but I did, and so did some of you. I did all of that and achieved six associate's degrees, four in engineering with concentrations including mechanical, civil, and aerospace, another in mathematics, and one more in physics. Yes, they set forth a legacy, but I was the one who added to the story. I was the last of this generation who represented the family name here with pride. I didn't know how much work it would be getting here, but I'm glad I started this journey and following in my family's footsteps and leaving my own impression behind and not just theirs. It took hours of days in class and months of doing classwork, but I can look back on all of that and know that I did well, and I can smile knowing I not only made my family proud, but myself prouder. I'm happy to know that I'm able to share my success with my family and my friends, and some of my best friends, the Dream Team, Nicholas Wilson and Jacob Chapman, and I could not have done it without you guys. And a special shout out to my professor, Alan Drog and Edwin. I can look back on all the time I spent here and know it was worth it. To my entire graduating class, I hope you are able to say the same. I hope you're able to look back on your time here and say I left my mark, made my own way, and made it better than those that came before me. Because I can proudly say I did that. Thank you.
Thank you. Great job. You've represented the entire graduating class well. We have a graduating class full of inspiring stories like these: student success, academic excellence, and completion. Congratulations. Cecil College is proud to recognize student excellence and academic achievement. At this time, I'd like to ask Dr. Christopher Castillo to recognize the Outstanding Student Awards.
The Donald M. Tomey Outstanding Student Award recognizes those students who are graduating with an associate's degree, have the highest grade point average as of December, and have taken all of their coursework at Cecil College. This prestigious honor is in honor of Donald M. Tomey, a longtime friend and supporter of Cecil College and its foundation. Today, I am pleased to present the college's most prestigious academic award to the outstanding students who have met the established criteria. As I call your names, please join me at the podium and proceed across the stage to be recognized. Matthew Todd Enlow. Evan Thomas LaPointe. Lauren Ashley LaPointe. Emma Bergen Neal. And Matthew Allen Wallace. On behalf of the faculty and the staff and the administration of Cecil College, we are pleased to honor each of you as the outstanding students for the class of 2023, and we wish you much success in your future endeavors. Congratulations.
I'm Dr. Veronica Doherty. I'm the Dean for Arts and Sciences. I want to extend my personal congratulations to all of you. Most of you have bright, beaming faces right now, and some of you are, never mind. But I have to say, my, you have all grown. I remember when you were this tall. No, seriously, I do remember the first day of classes when some of you would walk around the halls on Monday looking for your Tuesday classes, or worse yet, on Tuesday looking for your Monday classes. Other than that, my job, what I'm supposed to officially say, is to introduce our song, our singer today, June. I always like the opportunity to brag about our adjunct faculty. June Sa is an adjunct faculty in our music department. She will be singing You'll Never Walk Alone.
When you walk through a storm, hold your head up high and don't be afraid of the dark. At the end of the storm, there's a golden sky and a sweet silver song of a lark. Walk on through the wind, walk on through the rain, though your dreams be tossed and blown. Dreams be told.
Thank you, June. I'm supposed to say that was a wonderful performance. It reminded me of some tough times that song got me through, so thank you very much.
Good afternoon, everyone. I'm Dr. Christy Dreyer. Good afternoon, candidates, faculty, friends, guests, and colleagues. This is time to truly celebrate the achievement of our graduates. Mr. Mortensen, Dr. Bolt, with the recommendation of the faculty and the approval of the Board of Trustees, I am honored to present the graduation candidates for the class of 2023. I would like to invite Matthew Todd Enlow, Evan Thomas LaPointe, Lauren Ashley LaPointe, Eben Bergen-Neal, and Matthew Allen Wallace, our 2023 outstanding students, and Dominic A. Harris, Julia Arion Davis, and Camille Isabella Gaskell, our student speakers, to join me at the podium to begin the presentations. Dominic A. Harris, Associate of Applied Science in Management. Julia Arion Davis, Associate of Arts in Psychology. Graduating with honors, Camille Isabella Gaskell, Associate of Science in Engineering, with concentrations in Engineering Science, Mechanical, Aerospace, and Civil, Associate of Science in Mathematics, and Associate of Science in Physics. Graduating with highest honors, outstanding student Matthew Todd Enlow, Associate of Arts in General Studies. Graduating with highest honors, outstanding student, Evan Thomas LaPointe, Associate of Arts in General Studies. Graduating with highest honors, outstanding student, Lauren Ashley LaPointe, Associate of Arts in General Studies. Graduating with highest honors, outstanding student, Emma Bergen-Neal, Associate of Arts in General Studies. Graduating with highest honors, outstanding student, Matthew Allen Wallace, Associate of Arts in General Studies. Liam Brian Allen, Associate of Science and Engineering, Mechanical, Aerospace, and Civil Engineering, Department Award winner in Math, Engineering, and Physics. Graduating with highest honors, Astoria Brooke, Associate of Applied Science in Criminal Justice, Associate of Arts in Psychology, Department Award winner in Human Services, Criminal Justice. Graduating with highest honors, Jacob Chapman, Associate of Science in Mathematics, Associate of Science in Physics, Departmental Award winner for Math, Engineering, Physics, and Departmental Award winning for Physics. Graduating with highest honors, Candy Lynn Greenleaf, Associate of Arts in Social Work, Departmental Award winner in Human Services Social Work. Graduating with honors, Robert James Harrigan, Associate of Applied Science in Visual Communications, Video Production Concentration, Departmental Award winner in Arts and Visual Communications, Video Production. Crystal Lee Lank, Associate of Science in Exercise Science, Departmental Award winner in Human Sciences, Exercise Science. Graduating with highest honors, Zachary Meehan, Associate of Science in Chemistry, Departmental Award winner in Science and Technology for Chemistry. Graduating with highest honors, John Oram, Associate of Applied Science and Management, Departmental Award winner in Business Sciences for Business. Chase Alexander Reese, Associate of Applied Science and Computer Science, Programming, Departmental Award winner in Science Technology for Computer Science. Graduating with highest honors, Kyle Jacob Reiset, Associate of Applied Science in Accounting, Departmental Award winner in Business Sciences Accounting. Mason Schaefer, Associate of Science in Biological Sciences, Environmental Science Concentration, Departmental Award winner in Science Technology for Biological Sciences. Graduating with highest honors, Trevor Patrick Sexton, Associate of Arts in Paralegal Studies, Department Award winner in Human Services for Paralegal. Graduating with highest honors, Julia Rose Shafransky, Associate of Science in Nursing, Departmental Award winner in Health Sciences for Nursing. Graduating with highest honors, Jaden Lachelle Watson, Associate of Arts in Teaching and Elementary Education, Departmental Award winner in Human Sciences for Education. Graduating with honors, Sarah Waddell, Associate of Arts in Psychology, Departmental Award winner in Human Sciences for Psychology. Bernard Gore Abok, Associate of Science in Public Health, Health Navigator Concentration. Nathaniel David Alexander, Associate of Science in Nursing. Graduating with honors, Anthony Scott Altvader, Associate of Applied Science in Visual Communication, Simulation Design, and Gaming Concentration. Graduating with highest honors, Stephen Altvader, Associate of Applied Science in Computer Science Programming. Graduating with honors, Monica Nicole Aponte, Associate of Arts and Psychology. Zachary Austin Ayers, Associate of Arts and General Studies. Graduating with honors, Lily Marie Bogrowski, Associate of Arts and General Studies. Graduating with highest honors, Emily Francine Baker, Associate of Arts and General Studies. Graduating with honors, Carly Baruca, Associate of Arts and General Studies. Angelina Rose Battaglia, Associate of Applied Science and Management. Morgan Nicole Bogus, Associate of Science in Nursing. Katrina Belfield, Associate of Applied Science in Visual Communications, Video Production Concentration. Sarah Marie Billingham, Associate of Science in Nursing. Mary Catherine Birdsall Hitchcock, Associate of Arts in General Studies. Maria Alexandra Bushka, Associate of Arts in General Studies. Bianca Marie Bonaparte, Associate of Science in Nursing. Graduating with honors, Riley Shane Brady, Associate of Applied Science in Visual Communications, Graphic Design and Multimedia Concentration. Caitlin Bryant, Associate of Science in Nursing. Bridge. Cameron Matthew Bridge, Associate of Arts in General Studies. Alyssa Ann Byrne, Associate of Applied Science in Accounting and Associate of Applied Science in Management. G. Janine Prado Cabarlas, Associate of Science in Nursing. Hope Rose Bright-Eyes Chavez, Associate of Arts in General Studies. Kelly Christy Van Dyke, Associate of Applied Science and Physical Therapist Assistant. Sarah F. Clausen, Associate of Arts in General Studies. Klontz? James Russell Klontz, Associate of Arts in General Studies. Corcoran? Ava Corcoran, Associate of Arts in General Studies. Emily Rebecca Cornish, Associate of Science in Nursing. Graduating with highest honors, Emily Michelle Custer, Associate of Arts in Psychology. Graduating with honors, Anne Marie Elizabeth Davenport, Associate of Arts in General Studies. Shelby Dawson, Associate of Arts in General Studies. Kristen Dolan, Associate of Applied Science in Marketing. Madison Jane Dye, Associate of Science in Nursing. Graduating with highest honors, Angela Ebling, Associate of Arts in General Studies and a Certificate in Health Sciences. Madeline Holly Ettinger, Associate of Arts in Psychology. Graduating with highest honors, Carly Elizabeth Esterling, Associate of Arts in General Studies. Diego Roberto Fernandez, Associate of Arts in General Studies. Graduating with highest honors, Annabelle Frances Finnegan, Associate of Arts in General Studies. Vanessa Forbes, Associate of Arts in Teaching in Early Childhood Education and Associate of Arts in Teaching in Elementary Education. Graduating with highest honors, Simone De La Foy, Associate of Arts in General Studies. Graduating with highest honors, Catherine Alexandra France, Associate of Arts in General Studies. Garrett Frock, Associate of Applied Science in Music, Audio Technology Concentration. Amy Guidrow, Associate of Applied Science in Transportation Logistics and Management, Certificate in Supply Chain Management. Lauren Gilbert, Associate of Applied Science in Agricultural Studies, Agriculture Concentration. Emily Hannah Gerton, Associate of Science in Nursing. Shade Janaya Givens, Associate of Arts in General Studies. Amanda Nicole Haroldson, Associate of Science in Nursing. Graduating with honors, Makai David Harkins, Associate of Arts in General Studies. Kevin Andrew Hart, Associate of Arts in General Studies. Isabella Vaughn Hatfield, Associate of Applied Science in Criminal Justice. Ada? Christelle Amanda Hayduck, Associate of Applied Science in Cybersecurity. Graduating with highest honors, Jude Frances Heath, Associate of Fine Arts and Performing Arts, Music Concentration. Jocelyn Arlene Henderson, Associate of Arts in General Studies. AJ Hinckley, Associate of Arts in General Studies. Graduating with highest honors, Julie Marie Hook, Associate of Arts in Psychology. Wait. That's why I'm waiting. Now, Taylor Joseph House, Associate of Applied Science in Cybersecurity. Haley Denise Hovader, Associate of Science in Nursing. Tammy Yvonne Howell, Associate of Applied Science in Accounting, Associate of Applied Science in Management. Graduating with highest honors, Rebecca Elaine Hugel, Associate of Arts and General Studies. Michaela Marie Hutzel, Associate of Arts and General Studies. Graduating with honors, Lillian Jackson, Associate in Business Management. Thank you. Rebecca Faye Jamison, Associate of Science in Nursing. Alex Johnson, Associate of Arts in General Studies. Taylor Elise Jones, Associate of Arts in General Studies. Fallon Sky Katz, Associate of Science in Computer Science. Ashley Nicole Kelly, Associate of Arts in Social Work. Graduating with honors, Casey Lee Kelly, Associate of Science in Nursing. Graduating with honors, Morgan Page Kennedy, Associate of Applied Science in Criminal Justice. Graduating with honors, John Kilby, Associate of Arts and General Studies. Shelby Renee King, Associate of Arts and General Studies. Andrew Stanley Klein, Associate of Arts and General Studies. Joshua Garrett Klein, Associate of Applied Science in Management, Associate of Applied Management in Sports Management. Graduating with honors, Kaylin Klingis, Associate of Arts in General Studies. Graduating with honors, Elise Knapp, Associate of Arts in Secondary Education. Graduating with highest honors, Isabel Grace Lamagna, Associate of Arts in General Studies. Graduating with honors, Grace Elizabeth LaPointe, Associate of Science in Nursing. Jason L. Lawrence, Associate of Arts in General Studies. Andrea M. Lee, Associate of Arts in General Studies. Graduating with honors, Stephanie Nicole Levering, Associate of Arts in General Studies. Graduating with honors, Cerise Elizabeth Lazama, Associate of Applied Science in Marketing. Zachary James Lockard, Associate of Applied Science in Management. Graduating with honors, Isabel Seifer Lopez, Associate of Applied Science in Marketing. Cammie Lyons, Associate of Arts, General Studies. Natalie Ann Mackey, Associate of Arts in General Studies. Rebecca Holly Mason, Associate of Science in Nursing. Madison Evangelista McCain, Associate of Arts in Psychology. Graduating with honors, Erica Irene McDaniels, Associate of Science in Nursing. Shauna McHugh, Associate of Arts in General Studies. Jacqueline Ashley McIntyre, Associate of Science in Nursing. Graduating with honors, Devin Ray McCann, Associate of Science in Nursing. Brian McMenamin, Jr., Associate of Arts in Teaching and Elementary Education. Patrick Kelly McNally, Associate of Applied Science in Criminal Justice. Natalie Meixel, Associate of Arts in General Studies. Jocelyn Janine Melvin, Associate of Arts in General Studies. Maria Minuk, Associate of Arts in General Studies. Joanna Missimer, Associate of Arts in Social Work. J.C. Ann Mitchell, Associate of Applied Science and Agricultural Sciences, Agribusiness Concentration. Brandy Jo Moyer, Associate of Science in Nursing. Jonathan Angel Montez, Associate of Applied Science and Management. Graduating with honors, Donovan Patrick Moore, Associate of Applied Science and Criminal Justice. Jacob Mullins, Associate of Applied Science and Computer Science, Programming. Selena Catherine Oceanic, Associate of Arts in General Studies. Liz Beatty Ortiz Castellano, Associate of Science in Nursing. Gregory Juliana Owens, Associate of Applied Science in Criminal Justice. Griffin James Norman, Associate of Applied Science in Management. Graduating with honors, Sharon Ezra Paris, Associate of Science in Public Health Generous Concentration. Benjamin E. Perry, Jr., Associate of Arts in General Studies. Lindsay Ryan Parson, Associate of Science in Nursing. Graduating with highest honors, Mino Patel, Associate of Arts in General Studies. Amanda Leanne Pepper, Associate of Applied Science in Marketing. Mike Tuan Pham, Jr., Associate of Arts in General Studies. Anthony Samuel Piccolo, Associate of Applied Science in Marketing. Hannah Pierce, Associate of Arts in General Studies. Graduating with honors, Megan Pike, Associate of Science in Nursing. Mary Catherine Poldesak, Associate of Applied Science in Criminal Justice. Sarah Potter, Associate of Arts in General Studies. Nicholas Hunter Powers, Associate of Applied Science and Management. Graduating with honors, Elizabeth Nicole Ramey, Associate of Arts and General Studies. Vanessa Jari Reed, Associate of Science and Health Sciences. Matthew Emilio Renzo, Associate of Science and Engineering, Mechanical, Aerospace, and Civil Concentrations. Tanner Sage Repetto, Associate of Arts and General Studies. Molly Trace Reynolds, Associate of Science in Nursing. Caitlin Riggs, Associate of Applied Science in Management. Joshua Robinson, Associate of Arts and General Studies. Kristen Elizabeth Rodecker, Associate of Science in Nursing.
Michaela.
Michaela Nicole Rogers, Associate of Applied Science and Agricultural Sciences, Agribusiness Concentration.
Rador.
Guinevere K. Rador, Associate of Arts in General Studies. Zane David Romberger, Associate of Applied Science and Computer Science Programming.
Lewis, correct?
Jeremiah Lewis Sanders, Associate of Arts and General Studies. Graduating with distinction, Amanda Lynn Satterfield, Certificate in Cybersecurity. Graduating with honors, John Smith, Associate of Science in Chemistry. Woo! Kevin Schumann, Associate of Applied Science in Accounting. Hayden Riley Seaver Devine, Associate of Arts in Secondary Education. Natalie Marie Sexton, Associate of Arts in Teaching in Elementary Education. Kai Sharp, Associate of Applied Science in Visual Communications, Communications Concentration. Madison Alexis Sheets, Associate of Applied Science in Management. Vernon Nathaniel Simmons III, Associate of Arts in General Studies.
Saya.
James Charles Sayoc Jr., Associate of Science in Engineering, Chemical Concentration. Graduating with honors, Sandalay Siri Wardana, Associate of Arts in General Studies. Cassidy Skozik, Associate of Science in Biological Science, Environmental Science Concentration.
Snelling.
Samantha K. Snelling, Associate of Arts in Social Work. Rafael A. Solano, Associate of Applied Science in Sports Management. Jordan Nicole Steele, Associate of Science in Nursing. Elijah Robert Strickland, Associate of Arts in General Studies. Brooke Elizabeth Strong, Associate of Arts in General Studies. Graduating with highest honors, Megan Grace Talbot, Associate of Arts in General Studies.
Say your last name.
Marie Teresa Carter Terawelli, Associate of Applied Science in Accounting. Marlena Victoria Tapman, Associate of Science in Nursing. David Lorenzo Terry, Jr., Associate of Arts in Social Work. Ariel Elizabeth Thomas, Associate of Science in Nursing. Lucas David Umbarger, Associate of Arts in General Studies.
Say your last name.
Graduating with highest honors, Caitlin Marie Velvakis, Associate of Arts in General Studies. Nicholas Austin Van Bergen, Associate of Arts in General Studies. Dylan Van Dyke, Associate of Fine Arts and Performing Arts, Music Concentration. Graduating with honors, Tara Marie Vinoy, Associate of Arts in Addictions and Chemical Dependency.
Say your last name.
Cordero. Frank Villasana Cordero, Associate of Arts in General Studies. Graduating with honors, Melinda K. Ward, Associate of Science in Nursing. Graduating with honors, Madeline Elizabeth Warnick, Associate of Arts in Teaching and Elementary Education. Marcel Warnick, Associate of Arts in General Studies. Stasia Ezriel Washington Campbell, Associate of Fine Arts in Art and Design, Interactive and Motion Arts Concentration. Graduating with highest honors, Catherine Noel Weiss, Associate of Arts in General Studies. Graduating with highest honors, Griffin Charles Weinert, Associate of Arts in English, Department Award winner in English Humanities and English. Carrington White, Associate of Arts in Psychology. Lane Austin Weissmiller, Associate of Applied Science in Cybersecurity. Graduating with honors, Allison Wiggins, Associate of Arts in General Studies. Graduating with highest honors, Jemima Stephanie William, Associate of Applied Science in Management. Nicholas Austin Wilson, Associate of Applied Science in Mathematics. Graduating with highest honors, Julian York, Associate of Arts in General Studies. Dr. Bolt, I am pleased to present the class of 2023. I request that you confer the degrees and certificates as recommended by the faculty and approved by the Board of Trustees.
Would the candidates for graduation please turn and face the audience? Thank you. And now, by the power vested in me by the Maryland Higher Education Commission and on the recommendation of the faculty with the approval of the Board of Trustees of Cecil College, I now confer upon you the associate degree or certificate with all the rights and privileges appertaining thereto. Graduates, you may now move your tassels to the left side. Honored guest, I am pleased to present the graduating class of 2023. Graduates, you may be seated. I'd like to say thank you to everyone who worked so hard to make these exercises a success. Special appreciation goes to the members of the graduation committee, Kelsey Ladix, Chair, Aaron Jesse, Cheryl Davis Robinson, Dr. Cynthia Horton, Daniel Combs, DJ Winfrey, Deanna Gischel, Keith Brown, Kim Shepard, Matthew Stemple, Misty Buckworth, Dr. Nancy Norman Marzella, Ruth Byers, Sarah Snyder, Sherry Hartman, Sandra McKeever, Dr. S. Tamika Swan, Dr. Veronica Dougherty, Walt Bupre, and Wyatt Thompson. The faculty, yes, absolutely. The faculty and staff invite the graduates and your families and friends to enjoy a reception immediately following the ceremony in the Technology Center, Building D, Room 208, and also please enjoy outside in our beautiful quad area. At the conclusion of my remarks, I ask that everyone please stand and remain standing in your places until the conclusion of the recessional. Graduates, as the ceremony ends, you'll follow us one last time. Congratulations, class of 2023.